Speaking of school, the first Chicago area students head back to class next week. Well, being organized can help the school year run smoothly for both students and parents.
And joining us now with some tips on how to do that is Bethany Braun Silva, a parenting, entertainment, and lifestyle editor. Hey, Bethany.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Good, good. Thanks for being with us.
Yeah. So how is it that you have gotten into the art of organization, especially as it relates to this time of year, this back to school time?
You know, as a mom myself, I struggle with organization, but especially during back to school time is when I find it to be the most important. So I have three tips that I do with my own family. I have three tips that I do with my own family that I think will really, really help your viewers as well.
Okay. Nice. Well, let's kick it off. I believe the first tip that we have up is label everything. Is that right?
Label everything. Inchbug labels are my family's go-to. As you can see here, you can get your kids' names personalized on these labels. My boys are about 3 years apart in age, so they started to share things, sometimes unbeknownst to the other, which could lead to fights. So I find that when I label... So I find that when I label their stuff, it really just is a lifesaver and really a time saver during those busy mornings.
Nice. Okay, so moving on to the next one, we have charts and schedules. Where and how do those play a role?
My family really got in the habit of chore charts and dry erase schedules while we were virtual learning at home. So you can purchase a dry erase calendar on Amazon or go to your local Target, wherever you shop. So what my family loves to do is we sit down Sunday night and we erase the events from the week before, and we sit down and we take a minute to plan out the next week's event so that there's no surprise bake sales or practices or anything that we're going to just, you know, be shocked by the night before. And it really gives my kids a chance to see what's on the schedule and maybe give them some autonomy as well.
Parents won't be surprised with that last minute art activity that was due.
I need
100 cupcakes by tomorrow.
That's what Jewel is for. Anyway, so great tips. I've got another one listed here. Create a family command center.
A family command center. It's basically just a hub where you can incorporate that dry erase calendar, throw up a bulletin board for important reminders, add hooks to throw up your keys or your face masks, which kids will now need every day. It's just like, and a great way for your family to communicate with each other. We're out of milk, hun, or pickups at 3, leave little notes. It's just a hub, and I suggest putting it in a high traffic area like your mudroom or your kitchen where eyes will be on it each and every day. Again, another way to kind of offset some of that responsibility for mom and dad and really help kids to sort of stay organized on their own.
Nice.
So you said you're a mom yourself. You gave us some really great tips. I assume that you employ all of these tips that you've given us. Is there perhaps something though that you feel that even though you are the editor, the expert as it would be at this moment, that you're still learning, that you're still trying to get a handle on yourself as we prepare for back to school?
Yeah, so what I need to get a real handle on, and I'm glad you asked because it's something I'm discussing with my husband later, that my kids are in different schools. So we're based in New York City. So we need to figure out, transportation, getting one kid here and another kid there. This is the first year we're going to have to get our kids in different schools. So these are conversations. If you're in the same boat, have them now so that, again, you're not thinking about this the night before and, you know, trying to figure out carpool schedules or train schedules. Get it all out of the way now so that our kids can have the school year they deserve, which is a nice, as calm and peaceful as it possibly can be.
Parents can also have that peace of mind going into that
That's
school
true.
Year too.
It's not just the kids, right? The parents have to have some calm to them as well.
Awesome.
Absolutely. And it's great to just get ahead of those things.
For sure. Yeah.
Bethany, thank you so much for joining us and giving us all those tips. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me.